guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Venice, aka Bougie Bambi, and today I'm back again with another exciting video. So today, what are we doing? So today I'm going to show you guys my hair routine, what I do for my hair to grow. So I recently unbraided my hair, I think 2-3 days ago, and as soon as I was done unbraiding it, I like just twisted it and left it like this for the days that like followed up. One thing I did was to do my rice water, which I kept for over a week now. Oh, I think, yeah, for over a week and a day at the moment. So yes, sometimes I do my like my rice water for a month, and the ones I do for a month to prevent it from like smelling bad, because sometimes it does smell bad, I put in the rice, add in essential oils, water, and also put in a lemon zest, or like the skin of the lemon, and also some of its juice, so that the rice water does not smell. So let me show you how that looks. The one I have, so I actually put it in like any random container I have at the moment, and this is the one I saw. And because I knew I wasn't going to do this for like a long time and it wasn't going to smell, I didn't put any lemon or like lemon juice or lemon whatever in there. The only thing I have in there is like the rice, and unlike most people that strain out the rice, I do not strain out my rice. I leave my rice in there, and I also added water on it. And because I'm like a very big fan of coconut, so every single thing I like to use coconut, I also add coconut in there. So this is how the water looks like. I'll be transporting this water into my my container. Put this into this to like spray my hair. Okay, so I have poured my rice water into this. As you can see, I have my hair all braided into sections. I mean, it doesn't have to be this way. Mine is only like this because I recently braided my hair, as I said before, and I didn't want to have my hair all tangled up while I sleep and everything like that. So yes, my hair is this way, and I mean, it doesn't have to be. And since mine is like this, I'll just like continue with this. So as I unbraid every single one, I kind of like pour a bit of rice water in there all the way from like the very root. Okay, I think I need to get into the bathroom now. Okay, so I just got into the bathroom, so I don't like make the whole place wet. I'm gonna like job to clean. So I kind of like pour the rice water in my hair from like the very roots, and as I unbraid each one of like the braids I have, I pour it down there. You just need to make sure that you actually like get it to the roots, because what then is the point of using the rice water if it doesn't like get to your roots? Because that's the only way you'll be able to grow your hair. If like, so you have to do this so like you have it done like all over. And I just wanted to say this for those who have also been asking me on how to get edges. When you're doing this, it is like important that you also like get in the front hair too. So like every single front side also gets a bit of the rice water with coconut oil, because that would help you to like your hair to grow a bit at those sides. Okay, so now I'm just trying to like massage the rice water into my hair. I'm trying to like get it to every single place, every part of my hair, the back, the front, everywhere. So now I'm done putting the rice water in my hair. I now have to cover my hair for 15 minutes. So now let's just go have the hair covered for 15. Okay, so I have my hair wrapped in plastic, and to make sure the water doesn't drip, I also like to wrap a scarf around it. I mean, if you have like a plastic shower cap, you could also use it, but I wouldn't advise that because there's a chance that your cap will start to smell, and if you don't like the smell of your rice water, I advise you not to do it. Okay, so it's been an hour now. So basically I kept this for an hour. I kept this on for an hour, and it's time to take it off. Okay. Okay, we've taken this off. So now this is how my hair is. Still looks kind of like the same, just that now it's like a bit, now it's a bit wet. But like, yeah. And just an extra info, sometimes I do break an egg, add like my, as usual, my coconut oil in there. Now let's move on to the washing aspect of it. Okay, so this is what I use. Inecto Essentials Pure Coconut. This is the conditioner and this is the shampoo. So I basically use the same thing. As I said before, I am like really, really into anything coconut. So my hair, I use a lot of coconutty, is that a word? I use a lot of coconutty stuff in this, so anything coconut, I'm down for it. And I read somewhere that it's also a really good idea to put coconut oil into your shampoo, because then it turns into, I think, a leave-in conditioner. So you could try this, but I've never tried that before, but I did read that somewhere. But so yeah, this is the shampoo I use for my hair and the conditioner. So let's just get right into that. Okay, so I just wanted to also add this little information. I like to use warm water for my hair. Sometimes I also go for hot. Just be careful not to go for too hot, because I feel like the days when I use like really hot water, it feels like my hair is falling off one by one. So just go for like lukewarm water. So I'll probably say like some more hair and see. Okay, yeah, somewhere like here. That works, because that's not like, that's not too cold and that's not too hot either. This is just how much I lather my hair with the shampoo. I actually put in a lot, because when it's like this, I feel like it's easier for me to wash it. So okay, so this is my hair after using the shampoo. I haven't put in the conditioner yet, so when I do that, I'll show you guys how it looks. So this is after the shampoo, and I washed it twice. Okay, so now I'm like fully drenched, and this is after using the shampoo. I put a little bit of conditioner in there, but it's not enough, so I need to add more. And the thing is, there are days when I section my hair when I'm putting the conditioner in, and there are other times when I just don't, and I just like try to make sure I get the conditioner everywhere, which you have to do like systematically, I guess. You need to know which part you've already put your shampoo, so you don't like pull it at the same place over and over again. First time I put it in there, I started from this side, so this time around I'm going from here. Okay, so I have rinsed out all the shampoo and conditioner in my hair, and this is how my hair looks now. So let's just dry it. Okay. So I think this is a bit dried, but then I also like to dry it naturally, which means I'll tie up my hair in the towel and leave it on for like 10-20 minutes. And so now I'm just going to wait for a bit for my hair to dry whilst I clean my face. So now I'm back, my hair is dried. One thing I would like to say is, right after washing my hair, I don't really like to comb through it and get my afro back. One thing I like to do is directly put in the pomades, like the hair foods and everything, and then when I'm done, just braid it like that. And then after a day or two, I unbraid it and comb it and then re-braid it again. Like, that is my protective style of what I do for my hairstyle. Okay, so now that my hair is dried and after all the long talks, what I like to do next is put in my coconut oil. So what do I do then? Okay, so I kind of like take a bit of the oil. I don't melt it. Like, I know some people melt it first before putting it into their hair, but I don't. So I have like a bit in my hands now. Like, it's, you know, it's notable. I have a bit in my hands now. I've put in a bit of coconut oil. It is now time to divide it into sections and then braid my hair and add more coconut oil in. Okay, so now now I'm on the last braid. Okay, so now I'm done putting every single thing in my protective braids. Okay, so that is all when it comes to my routine. So this I'm going to keep for 2 days, and in 2 days I will unbraid it and show you guys how I comb my hair and how it would look like when it's done. Keep in mind that what I've just braided is my hair at its like shrinkage position. Okay guys, so this is the second day, and today's the day when I unbraid like what I have here and comb it so you guys see how my hair actually looks like. And this was the bottle I put in the rice water, but now I have been just like plain water with a bit of coconut oil, because I don't like to comb my hair when it's like very very dry. And to comb my hair I have an afro comb, and I also have like a brush. You can really use like any brush. I also like to use a brush. I do have bigger combs, but I don't really use them regularly unless I'm going to like braid my hair or something. I have like a style for it. Okay, so I do this unbraiding one by one because then it's easier for me to comb through. It's easier than when I comb, I unbraid every single thing at once and pour the water in, then I start combing, because with that I feel like sometimes I pull my hair and it's very painful. Okay, so I have unbraided the first one now. Okay, it is really dry, because if you guys remember that day, the only thing I put in was the coconuts, was the coconut oil. So you just like, you just feel like just a tiny bit in there. That's all. I just need it not too wet, because then it'll be like I just washed my hair all over again. So just a little bit. And I did say I used something else in my hair, which I was going to show to you guys, but then I forgot to put it there. But this is what I use, and the hair foods I use don't really matter, because sometimes I change them, but at the moment this is what I'm using. And well, the price is there. I got it for €6, but yeah, this is it. You're combing your hair, like this is one tip, always start from like the bottom, because when you go start all the way from the top and there are any tangles down here, then you end up pulling your like the whole hair, and it really hurts. And the problem also with that is like when there is a knot and you start pulling from the bottom, the knot ties like more tighter, and when you're pulling it off you have to like really pull. I know this from experience, and most of the time you end up losing the hair you are trying to pull out. So I just wanted to add this. The secret to combing your hair is trying to lose like the minimum hair as possible. So you always have to be gentle with your hair so you don't lose way too much hair. Because if you do, then what's the whole point of like actually trying to grow your hair if you're just going to lose it again? Okay, so to prevent the hair from getting in the way of me unbraiding the other ones, I have decided to braid this into a twist. You do this all over. Okay, so I'm now done with the last, combing the last braid, which means now we can unbraid every single thing and then comb everything together. Well, I could keep combing my hair if I wanted it bigger, but I think this way looks nice. So if I wanted to go out, this look is perfect enough. So if you want your hair to go like this, well, go through the steps I do and be consistent with it. Thank you so much for watching, and do not forget to click on the subscription button if it still happens, and also press the notification bell so you will be notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much, and until next time, it's your girl, and it's okay, we should come meet.